they can see out. Now, what they see, we don't know. Yeah. But he can see out just as well as you can see in. Oh, and the grouper, when he gets like white splotches on him, that means he's excited.
Oh, he gets white spots?
Yeah, he gets white spots on him.
Oh, Maury thinks he's going to get more food.
Yeah, he's looking for something to eat. Neil already fed you. Yes. And we try to have the same.
Quite a few of them. He's interested in that rock.
Is this your cell phone case or
something? Do you have a cell phone case?
No. Oh, no. Thank you, though.
See what it is at State
Fair. See, they got one there.
I've been told that it's brushing against them that does it, but I don't know that that's right. That's the...
Very abruptly.
It's like he's performing.
Is it the same one that's been here for several years? Or do they change
them? They do change them out. They have a research laboratory in the back. And
all right.
They've got 8 or 10 or more.
All right.
Usually. So I can't say. I'm not sure.
That is amazing. Yeah, he's half brown and half white, right down the middle right now. It's just incredible that they can do that.
Yeah.
And a few minutes ago, he was totally brown.
Really?
Oh, he can change almost instantaneously. And usually, if he's swimming around and he's against, you know, the lighter background, he'll be gray like that. And if he's against the back, he'll be brown. But to just sit there like that and be half and half is pretty incredible. I haven't seen him do that before. It is. The diversity is amazing. The camouflage of this place is just
amazing. Not quite a straight line up.
No, not quite, but almost.
think that's a good one.
To get this one. This one's special. Oh, back up.
Put your fingers in front of it.
Okay, but quick, take it the other way too.
I'm taking a movie.
Oh, I don't want to do that.
Well, I do.
Just take
I don't
it.
Care what.
Oh, look at the fins. Really pretty fins.
This is the one that gets me in. The one that gets me is the one that's wet.
They were head to head.
He was on top of them.
Yeah.
Isn't that sweet? Oh, look at that.
Oh, well, he's bumping the turtle up in the air.
This one's going to get in the act now.
Okay.
He's jealous. Look at that, right on top of it. That pro, I never would have expected that.
Oh, hi, baby. How are you? The turtle kind of rides on the manatee.
Yeah, yeah, it almost like kissing.
Yeah. Isn't it sweet? The turtle can't see much.
They get along, boy.
He's getting his brain better, so maybe that's why.
Oh, it said he's brain damage.
Who is the turtle?
Yeah, he got
run into. Dude, look at the scar he's got on.
He got run into by a
motorboat
that left him partially blind.
Oh, so they're taking care of him.
Yeah, maybe.
Oh, isn't that nice?
Oh, there he goes. Whoa!
He's fighting all the way down.
So will they procreate or have they been
fixed? Oh yeah, they will, but not for some time.
Oh, oh they're young.
About 2 years late.
Oh, now. They're young. Oh, yeah. Okay. Yeah.
So those are the parts I was talking about. You'll see that it is a rose, and that is for our American alligator. Her name is Rose. So target training is one of the first things we teach our animals. It brings our animals over to us, they're focused on us. And of course, we have multiple animals on exhibit, helping us separate them for feeding. So you'll see Sophia, she has a blue target. She's one of our special canid. And we do use positive reinforcement training with these animals. It's basically reinforcing the behaviors that we're asking for and ignoring any unwanted behavior. And these guys are very food motivated, so we're going to offer them food as their primary reinforcement. So what they're eating is a special pork-related diet called crocodilian chow. And it's basically a mixture in a biscuit form with lots of vitamins and minerals that they need to be healthy and happy. Now this target training is important because it also helps us build up with more complex behaviors. So our main goal for training our animals is to have them participate in their own veterinary care. So basic targeting like this can build up to maybe being led onto a scale to be weighed, maybe train them for voluntary blood draws, or even to open their mouths so you can check their teeth. So basically it can be stressful for them that we have to take good care of them. We train it and we turn it into a positive experience. Now, if you do ever see American alligators out in the wild, there are some differentiating features. Females for American alligators can get up to 10 feet, so even though Rose is smaller than the spectacled caiman right now, she will get larger. Spectacled caiman do only get up to 4.5 feet. Now, our American alligator is going to be black to dark gray with brown tones on the back and yellow and white bellies. Where our spectacled caiman are going to be olive to deep brown. And our American alligator has a broader, more round snout, and the lower teeth are not visible in a closed mouth. Where our caiman are going to have a slightly pointier, more triangular head, and a bony ridge in front of their eyes, which is actually where they get their name, that spectacle with them. Now, warm water and sunlight are important because these animals are ectotherms. So that basically means that they need to absorb heat from their environment for their bodies to function. Animals, including us, are endotherms because we produce enough body heat internally to regulate our temperature. So during colder times of the year, the alligators and caimans' metabolism is slower, so they need to feed less often. And any time of year, they will need less food than a mammal of the same size. So we offer these guys food about once or twice a day. But they may not necessarily be hungry. Feed reptiles that don't compete as often as they are river otters, 5 times a day because they have very quick metabolisms. Now we also have another crocodilian species that isn't out on exhibit. On this exhibit, it's in our old baby exhibit, and that's a
Thank you.
haven't got one rid of hold of it. I'm gonna let go either. Huh. He got out of it. Nope. He's got a. No, he got out. She got out of it.
It's a viper pit here. Seahorses. Well, one looks like it's pregnant. And it gets the male.
Could be a male.
Yeah.
Hmm.